Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate, and it was our annual DevRel barbecue this week. So summer has officially started, well, at least in the Northern Hemisphere. So my shirt today is Supreme, which kind of makes me roll my eyes too. But hey, it is purple and it has a keyboard, so I'm into it. And actually, real quick, there's some breaking news. Taylor Swift, who is the queen of my universe, just announced that she has a new album out called Lover that'll be out in August. And I know people are like, well, what does this have to do with DevRel? And I'm like, well, Swift on security. Did you not know this? So anyway, all right, but enough about overpriced streetwear and Taylor Swift, the best person ever. Let's get into this week's dev news. So first up, in a recurring segment that I like to call Bruno's Java Corner, there are a couple of cool updates for the Java developers out there. So last year, Microsoft Azure sponsored the Adopt OpenJDK project, and Adopt OpenJDK uses infrastructure, build, and test scripts to produce pre-built binaries from the OpenJDK class libraries, and then offers a choice of either the OpenJDK hotspot or Eclipse Open J9 VMs. So I want to announce that we are sponsoring this for another year, which is awesome. And that program is part of the next bit of news, which is that there is now a special Visual Studio Code installer for Java devs. And so this package can be used as a clean install or to update for existing environments to add Java or Visual Studio Code to your development environment. And so once downloaded and opened, it automatically detects if you have the fundamental components in your local development environment, including the JDK, Visual Studio Code, and essential Java extensions. So Java devs or people who want to get started with Java now have a really easy way to code in Java using Visual Studio Code. And the installer is available for Windows right now, but the team is working on a Mac version as well. And so links to download the new installer pack are in the description down below. Next up, .NET Core 3.0 Preview 6 is now available. And so this includes updates for compiling assemblies for improved startup. It has some optimization for applications for size with linker and event pipe improvements, and is also released new Docker images for Alpine on ARM64. And so I've got a link to the blog post explaining the changes down below, and it also does a really good job of giving an overview of all the stuff that came out with the .NET Core Preview 5 last month during my Microsoft Build. And the team is getting really close to switching to the master branch for .NET Core 3.0, and they really want your feedback. In some very exciting news, WSL2, that is the Windows Subsystem for Linux 2, it is now available in Windows Insider builds on the Insider Fast Ring. And so WSL2 is a really big update to WSL, and Windows 10 will be shipping a version of the Linux kernel alongside Windows, and the environment will be faster than it was in the past, and it'll also support stuff like native Docker connections. But because WSL2 has such a big architecture change around how it uses virtualization, there are some differences to the way that networking support works, and that is still being improved. Also, if you want to take advantage of the new file performance benefits, which are awesome, you will want to put the files that you access frequently with Linux inside your Linux root file system, and you'll be able to use Windows apps to access the Linux root file system as well. And there are also some new WSL commands available as well. Anyway, I want to be clear. This is for insiders, and the stuff that you'll find is broken, maybe a little bit buggy. But if you're like me and you can't wait to try this out, enjoy it on your insider's test machine or your VM, and then give the team feedback on Twitter or GitHub. In some other Visual Studio Code news, I want to give a shout out to my colleague Christian Nwamba, who is seriously one of the coolest people out there, because he wrote a blog post on Telerik's blog about the top 5 VS Code extensions for efficient JavaScript development. And in some AI news, I want to give a shout out to the TensorFlow team at Google, because they announced the TensorFlow 2.0 beta. And the plan is to have the release candidate for TensorFlow 2.0 available later this summer. And speaking of TensorFlow, I have a link down below about how you can use it to train and register TensorFlow models at scale using Azure Machine Learning Service. In other AI and ML news, ML.NET 1.1 is now out, and it includes updates for the model builder for Visual Studio. And so some of the highlights include things like added support for in-memory image type in iDataView, as well as a time series forecasting components, so that's in preview, and a new anomaly detection algorithm, which is also in preview. And in some version control news, Git 2.22 is now available. And so the GitHub team has a really great blog post highlighting some of the biggest features, which include the ability to interactively rebase merges, the ability to create branches from merge bases, and a new tracing mechanism called Trace2. And I've got a link to the GitHub blog post as well as the full release notes in the Git repository. Over on Channel 9 this week, we've got lots of fresh content. So first things first, over on Five Things, Burke and Eduardo from the Azure Functions team discuss five things you can do with serverless. Over on on.net, Diego and Christos show off how to port out the Entity Framework 6 code to Entity Framework Core. And over on the IoT show, Olivier shows off how over-the-air software updates for the Azure IoT Hub work using Mendaire.io. And so links to all those videos are down below. And now it's time for my pick of the week. So E3 was this week, and the Xbox team had so much amazing news to announce. Personally, I was like beyond excited to see Keanu Reeves on stage for Cyberpunk 2077, and it just felt right. But I did want to highlight what I think a lot of us old school users legit got excited about, and that is a new version of Microsoft Flight Simulator. That's right, it is back. And so, in fact, there's even going to be an insider program for this new version, which will give app geeks a chance to try out the game first and then offer feedback and recommendations to the team as they build it out. I'm going to link to the insider sign-up form for anybody who wants to access this game as soon as possible. I was honestly never that good at Flight Simulator, but now that I fly so much in like my work life, I'm kind of excited to give it another shot. Let me know your favorite E3 announcements in the comments, and also let me know your thoughts on all the other stories that we covered. And while you're there in the comments, go ahead and give this video a like on YouTube because it really helps keep the show going, and subscribe to the Microsoft Developer Channel for even more content. See you next time.